Hello students, welcome to Zoology classroom. This is Yel Mahesh, Assistant Professor of Zoology from Tara Government College, Sangareddy. In today's class, we are going to discuss about parental care in amphibians. This topic comes under BSc First Year Zoology, Second Semester. So first of all, let us know the definition of parental care. So parental care is the phenomenon of exhibiting care and concern by the animals towards their young ones. This is called as parental care. So parental care is very common in higher level of animals like mammals and apes. But this is also common in amphibians and some of the fishes. So there are three types of methods through which amphibians exhibit parental care. So one is selection of site, second one is formation of nest, third one is direct nursing by the parents. So let us see the first category of parental care, that is selection of site. So in selection of site, this selection of site can be seen in Rocco Forest Clegelee. So in Rocco Forest Clegelee, when it lays eggs, it will form a burrow near the water body on the bank. So it enters into the burrow and it lays eggs in a frothy mass. So once the eggs are fully hatched, once the larvae came out of these eggs, larvae they directly can enter into the water body. So in this way, they will select a site which is very close to the water body, on the bank of the water body, and they will construct a burrow with a sloping tunnel. And in the burrow, lay the eggs so that this special type of specially constructed burrow will give protection to the eggs. So no predator can enter there and can eat them. So in this way, for the protection of eggs, this Rocco Forest usually selects a special site and constructs a burrow, and in that burrow they lay the eggs. So another example for this selection of site can be seen in Gyrinophilus. This Gyrinophilus is also called as a spring salamander. So spring salamander, they will lay the eggs under the stones. So they will attach these eggs to the stone so that the water currents cannot wash these eggs along with them. So they select such sites that water current cannot damage the eggs or cannot wash the eggs. So, and another third example for selection of site is Amphioma, which is also called as commonly called as Congo eel. This Congo eel lays eggs in the underground holes, and this underground hole is selected to protect the eggs from the burrowing enemies. So in this way, Amphioma also selects a special site where the eggs will not have any predators in. And fourth example is Ichthyophis glutinosa. So Ichthyophis glutinosa also, these Ichthyophis also, they also will construct a burrow in the mud or sand. And in that burrow, they will lay the eggs, and they will coil around those eggs to protect them. So this is also an example for selection of sites. And fifth one is Rocco Forest Maculatus. So this Rocco Forest Maculatus, after laying the eggs, surrounding water will be made of frothy by limb movements, so it will move the hind limbs, so that with the help of these hind limbs, water will become a frothy, and this frothy water prevents the eggs from desiccation, and also the eggs cannot be seen by predators. So in this way, two types of protections are provided by the adults to these eggs. One is a protection from the predators, another one is protection from the desiccation. So this Rhacophorus maculatus also selects a site and it protects the eggs. And next example is Artiodax. This Artiodax also lays eggs in a hole in soil. And this hole will be protected by the both the parents, both mother and father will protect the eggs which are laid in the hole till the larva develops from there. And another example for the selection of site is Rhacophorus malabaricus. So this Rhacophorus malabaricus, they will live on the plants and they will lay the eggs in a special place where the developed larvae directly fall into the water. So even if they do not lay eggs in water, so, but the larvae, they need to live in the water. So they have to enter into the water. So as they are living on the trees, they will lay the eggs on the trees, or especially on the leaves. And underside of the leaves, and they will glue these eggs to the underside of the leaves, and they will lay in such leaves which are directly falling on the water body. So that what happens once the eggs are hatched, the hatched eggs directly they will fall into the water. So in this way, they also select a special site which helps the developed larvae or hatched larvae to enter into the water so easily. And one more example for selection of site is Hyla resinificus. So this Hyla resinificus also, it is also a tree frog. And this tree frog lines the holes of the tree trunks with beeswax. So it collects the beeswax and select some holes in the trunks and in order to give a watery environment or a watery site for this developing eggs. So they will glue the they will fill the holes with beeswax so that water which stagnates in that trunk hole cannot be evaporated or cannot be absorbed by the plant. So, and after lining the holes in the tree trunk with beeswax, they will lay eggs in that holes once the holes are filled with rainwater, so that eggs will be directly laid in a watery environment, so which helps for the development and development of the eggs. Once the larvae hatch from these eggs also, the larvae can live in that hole zone. So next example for selection of site is Cryptodactylus mystacinus. Cryptodactylus mystacinus. So this Cryptodactylus mystacinus, they will dig holes in the mud near the ponds, and they will fill the hole which was dug by them with a foam, and then they will lay the eggs in that foam. So hatched larvae will enter the water during the rains. So until the rains come, the larvae will survive that hole only. So next example for selection of site, type of parental care in amphibians is Triton. So this Triton lives in water. It is a Eurodelon. So this Eurodelon, it fixes eggs with aquatic weeds by glue. So it lays eggs in the water body and they will attach the eggs to this watery plants, especially aquatic weeds by glue. So that they will be protected and they will stay there only. Next, second category of parental care is formation of nest. So in the formation of nest, a very famous example for this formation of nest is hyla fiber. So this hyla fiber, it constructs a special mud nest near the water body, at the edge of the water body. So it will dig a hole and it will construct a special type of nest, which is called as mud nest. So, and into that mud nest, they will lay the eggs. Once the water body, once the rains come and this mud nest will be filled by the water, then the larvae enters into the water body, a pond. Next example under this formation of nest category is a Phyllomedusa hippo chandrilis. Phyllomedusa hippo chandrilis. So this Phyllomedusa hippo chandrilis, they also will lay eggs on the plants, and the eggs are glued to the plants. Eggs are glued to the plant leaves. So once the eggs are developed, the hatched larvae will enter into the water body, which is near this plant. So next example for this formation of nest category is Salamandrella keyserlingi. So this is a salamander, a Eurodilon. So these Eurodilons, they also lay eggs in a gelatinous case to the twigs and plant pots which are hanging in the water body. So they completely lay the eggs under water only. So the plants which are living in the water, so to the parts of those plants like twigs or branches, so to these branches they will attach a gelatinous layer. So in this gelatinous structure they will lay the eggs. So this gelatinous structure gives protection to the developing eggs until they hatch. Once the eggs are developed completely, the hatched larvae, they will leave this gelatinous bag and they will enter into the water body. So till the hatching is completed, the developing eggs will be protected in this gelatinous bag. So constructing or forming a gelatinous bag or gelatinous nest is the characteristic feature of Salamandrella keyserlingi. Next example for this second category of parental care in amphibians is Hyla nebulosa. Hyla nebulosa. So this Hyla nebulosa, it uses dry leaves to make egg nests. So by using dry leaves, they will construct an egg nest. So in this egg nest, they will lay the eggs. So in these organisms, the speciality is that there will be no larval stage. The eggs will directly hatch into a small adult looking like frogs. So this is a very, very special feature of this Hyla nebulosa. Constructing a egg nest with the help of dry leaves. Next example, next category is direct nursing by the parents. So under this category, so in the earlier categories, in the first category, the frogs are individuals. They will select a suitable place, a protective place for laying eggs. And in second category, the parents, they will construct a special site or a nest for the development of their young ones. In these two categories, after laying the eggs, most of them, they will not concerned about the future of those eggs. They will simply leave from that site, and the development and fate of those eggs will not be taken care by this organisms in the first group. strategy. That means till laying eggs only they will take care. So after laying the eggs, and they are not bothered about the future of the eggs. But in the third category, it is not like that. The parents, they are concerned about the future of the eggs also. Till the eggs are hatched, till the babies are born or larvae are born, they will take care of the eggs. So this is called as the direct nursing by the parents. So a famous example for this direct nursing by the parents is Alytes. So Alytes is a toad. The common name of this Alytes is midwife toad. So this midwife toad, it lay eggs and the eggs are attached to the intellects of these organisms. And these eggs are attached to the intellects with a glue-like gelatinous material. So it will carry these eggs on its intellects wherever it goes until the eggs are hatched. So in this way, by attaching them to the intellects and by providing protection to the legs, they will see that most of the eggs are develops into and hatches into larvae, young larvae. Next example for this direct nursing type of parental care is Pipa americana. So this Pipa americana is also a toad. So during the breeding season, the dorsal layer of dorsal skin of this organism becomes very soft, and the eggs laid by this organism will be hidden into this soft dorsal surface, and they will be hid into this dorsal surface of its body. So this Pipa americana carries the eggs till they hatch on its back. So in this way, it is taking a direct caring or direct care or direct nursing of its eggs. And Pipa is another example. Like Pipa americana also, in this also eggs are carried on their backs, but here in these organisms mostly females carry the eggs on their back in Pipa. So next example for this direct nursing category of parental care is Hyla goldii. So in Hyla goldii, a special case will be developed during the breeding season. So when they are not breeding, there is no special casing will not be seen on its back. But during the breeding season, a special case will be formed. Into the special casing, eggs will be adjusted or eggs will be accommodated in this special casing. And it will carry the special casing wherever it goes. And once the eggs are fully hatched, fully developed and hatched, the hatched larvae will leave the casing and they will enter into the mother body. So till then, the casing will be present on the parent's back. Next example for this direct nursing is Colestetes. Colestetes. So in this Colestetes also, eggs are carried on the back of these organisms. But especially in these organisms, males carry the larvae. And during the unfavorable conditions, these males, they will carry the larvae from one water body to the other water body. So in these organisms, as the larvae, they cannot travel from one place to another place on the terrestrial environment. So these larvae are carried to a safer water body or to a water body where plenty of water are available. They will be transferred by the father of those larvae. So in this Holostasis takes direct care of this larvae. Next example for direct nursing by parents is Cryptobatrachus evansii. So in this Cryptobatrachus evansii, dorsal skin develops many pocket-like structures on its back. And these pocket-like structures, they will house the eggs, and these eggs are not seen to the exterior. So, and in these pockets, the eggs will be developed till they hatch. And a very peculiar type of direct nursing can be seen in Rhinoderma darwini. So, Rhinoderma darwini, after laying the eggs, they will engulf the eggs, and the eggs will be hidden in this syringe or sound box. So they will protect the eggs inside their syringe or vice box. So once the eggs hatch into larvae, the larvae will be emitted by this larvae to its mouth into the surrounding water. This is a very, very peculiar feature seen in Rhinoderma darwini. So, next example is Phyllobatis. So, in this Phyllobatis, also like this Rhinoderma darwini, mother holds the newly hatched larvae in its mouth and transports them to the water. So, they will transport the newly hatched larvae into the water body by holding them in their mouth, and this will be done by the mother of those larvae. So this is also a very special type of direct nursing care provided by the Phyllobatis. And the next example is Desmognathus. So Desmognathus, after laying the eggs, it will convert those eggs into a chain-like structure, and it weaves the chain-like chain of eggs around its neck, and it carries them along with it. So in this way, a jewel of eggs will be constructed by the Desmognathus, and directly it wears it on their neck and provides protection for the eggs till they hatch. So next example for this direct nursing by parents is Amphioma congoil again. So in these organisms, in the previous case, we have seen that in first category, they will find a suitable place for the protection of larvae. So after laying the eggs, also this Amphioma, it will not take care of these eggs. It will take care of the future of the eggs. The female piles around the eggs and secretes some antifungal secretions to protect the eggs from the fungal attack. So in this way, Amphioma exhibits two types of parental cares. One is selection of sites. So it selects a suitable site, a safe site for the development of eggs. And after laying the eggs, also direct caring will be provided by the female, and they will secrete antifungal secretions to protect from the fungi, and they also will protect the eggs from the predator. So next example is Salamandra. So in Salamandra also eggs are protected by the parents, and they will keep the eggs inside their body only, inside their reproductive tract only. So female keeps the eggs inside its reproductive tract or uterus-like structure for almost 1 year. So it can keep the eggs inside its body for 1 year, and once the development is completed, they directly give birth to the larvae. So in this way, actually, eggs are developed in these organisms but X will not be laid by this organism. X will be kept inside the female reproductive system of the. Once the development also takes place, development of X also takes place inside the reproductive system of female, and the development requires almost 1 year of time. Once the eggs are fully developed and hatched, larvae will come out of mother's body. So this is also a very special type of direct nursing provided by this salamandra or tiger salamander. Next example is nectropharyngoids. So in this nectropharyngoids, entire embryological development also takes place in the uterus of the just like salamandra. So in salamandra and nectropharyngoids, in both these organisms, development of eggs takes place inside the reproductive system of the Next example is Gastrotheca. So in Gastrotheca also, on the dorsal surface, on the back of this female body, a special type of chamber will be developed. And this special chamber will have an opening near the back of these organisms. So the larvae, once they are laid, the laid larvae will be taken into this chamber, this opening. And development takes place inside this chamber, which is present on the back of the organism. And once the development is finished, the larvae leave this enters the surrounding. So this is about this parental care in amphibians. So in next class, we will be another topic.